Alright guys, how's it going? So let me show you a cool little trick. Now this actually comes from a conversation on Discord, and this is where I get schooled. Nothing unusual there. But I essentially wanted one object to be one colour, and in the reflection to be a different colour. Now the easiest way to do this is using the Lightpath node. Now one of the caveats being is you need to use Cycle's render engine. It's just one of these trade-offs that you need to deal with. So rather than setting everything up, here's the node setup. So I have an RGB node, which is orange, that goes into the principal shader, and this goes into a mix shader. And again, I have an RGB, which is now blue, that goes into a principal shader, and goes into the mixer. And we use a Lightpath node to kind of control the factor. So there's a few options we could actually use here. You could use as singular ray, or we could use as reflection ray. There's a few different ones. So you can see here, it works pretty well. And then the conversation went along the lines of, well, you could probably reduce the amount of nodes. I thought, damn. Now, there is advantages to using separate nodes. For example, I could put the metallic or specular up in one object, and I can kind of control the variable. But what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to quickly delete these nodes, and I'll look at an even easier setup. So again, we have the Lightpath node, and then all we do is have a mixed colour node. So we can set the colour values here. And you can see here, I'm actually using glossy depth. But check this out. Let's say, for example, I go to the ray length and I put that into the factor. And I move the mirror in and out. The closer I get to the object, the more of the secondary colour that it absorbs. And that's pretty much the Lightpath node. If you would like to see more on this, do me a favour guys, like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Follow me on Twitter, support me on Gumroad, you know what to do.